Hey guys, it's Velocity Reaper here, and we are back again with some more Monster Hunter World. Guys, we have changed once again, guys. I did a bunch of grinding yesterday to get this 6th set, one, because now we have moved up into higher tier, higher rank stuff, so now we have higher rank quests to do, which means we unlock higher rank gear as well. So as you guys can see, the Pelico is actually rocking the Zora Magdaros gear set, along with a little bit more powerful weapon. It's pretty useless. I don't think it was as good as the last weapon that I had him with, but it's okay. It's okay. It works. And then we are rocking, I actually don't know the name of this specific set. It's not specific to any character, but it's a bone set. And then we are actually rocking the Magda Magnus blade, which is kind of made from a lot of parts of Zora Magdaros. So it's pretty sick. It's pretty good. Very high damage and pretty good effect. It has a blast effect that does insane amount of damage, so it's really good for us for right now. And what we're hopping into right now is actually an investigation. It's a 3-star, so it's about 6 levels below us, so it should be relatively easy, but not too easy, you know. We have to hunt 2 monsters within 30 minutes, so it should be a lot of fun. And investigations are just another way to play through the storyline, grind different items, get rewards, stuff like that. And I need money as well, because I am like dirt broke right now. I mean, it's easy ways to grind money, but I'm dirt broke right now, so we're not doing too good in the money department. However, hold on, let's hit our box real quick, because she's gonna have a couple extra things for us to pick up. Yep, there we go. Very nice, very nice. So what are we lacking with? We got antidotes, we got 10 mega, holy crap, we have 10 mega potions? Jesus. All right, we're gonna keep those antidotes in hand, because the Puke Puke, which is one of the monsters, I don't know if we've fought him in an episode yet, so that'll be exciting for you guys. I don't think we fought either one of the monsters that we're about to fight in this, in an episode. So Puke Puke and the Kuluyaku, I believe is the name of the other one. I think I got that right. So we're gonna go ahead and hunt them in this huge area and hopefully fight them relatively quickly. Each one we have about 15 minutes to fight, but we're OP, so it shouldn't be too difficult. We just gotta find some tracks. However, I'm not seeing any tracks yet. Oh, well, we got Jagras on us. I'm not really interested in that. We'll bypass those Jagras. Head over this way. Yeah, guys, I really enjoy this game, and like I said, we're taking a step back from doing specific parts to switching to episodes because, oh, Kuluyaku tracks. which way are those heading, though? That's hard to tell. That one looked like it's heading in this direction, kind of down this way. What did they just find? Down over here, maybe? Yeah, okay, so they're definitely heading this way. Go ahead and jump off of this, please. Thank you. The whole dramatic jumps are great to me. Should be relatively close to it. Oh, they found another footprint right here. So down in here, maybe? Yeah, definitely this way. I mean, this is just a bunch of Jagras. Freaking Jagras, man, get off of me. They do, like, no damage to us. Like, honestly, I don't even care. So this way, maybe? We're not getting any more markers. Seems like it was there, but it's not there anymore, clearly. Probably should head back in there, to be honest. Just gonna, as soon as we get a little stamina here, because our characters have like zero stamina. Alright. Gotta wait again. I could eat an easy ration and get our stamina going a little bit more here. So it was in here, but then the tracks stopped cold, so see here, come on, give us more tracks. There's no outing of that, like, oh my god, holy crap, do I really have to eat an easy ration? We're just chilling, eating rations. All right, that gives us a bunch more stamina to use. All right, There's no... Yeah, there's just bone piles. There's no out. So the Kuliaku was in here and then it just disappeared, I guess? Or are they suggesting that it didn't... That it came out of this way? It's just a pain in the butt. I also think the Jaggers are stopping us from getting markers. Because that can... That does happen. Let me see. He would have had it this way. I think that's what... Holy crap, these Jaggers are freaking persistent. I'm just going to go ahead and kill these guys, dude. Holy crap. They're being so persistent. You guys saw right there. We hit for 105. That's like way higher than our other blades were hitting for. Also, there it is. The Kuliaku is up there. Wow, he is far. Okay. We gotta get going, boys. I'm also on a strict time schedule as well, so we gotta get this taken care of relatively quickly here. My campus printing service is offline, so I have to go all the way over to the library. So that'll be fun. The tracks were definitely not leading in this direction. Like, how would the Kuliaku have gotten over here? I don't know. We should get this done relatively quickly, though. I'm pretty sure it's a level 3 Kuliaku. These things aren't very vicious animals. It's not like fighting an Anjanath, so. What's up, buddy? Oh, hey, they're both here. What the heck? Honestly, though, I should get both of them aggroed on me. Of course. Kuliaku runs. Come here. I'm going to fight the Puke Puke, because I got markers for Kuliaku, so we're good on that. You look a little angry now. There's no reason to not fight the Kuliaku or the Puke Puke since it's right here. Oh my god, can you not be annoying and in my face? You gotta watch out for that tongue. I do know what that tongue do. It ain't good. Some nice good bursts out there. Oh, my blast effect popped off. Oh, we knocked it over. So we can get that good damage in. I don't know how our blast effect works. Like, they don't specify it necessarily. Obviously, I think it just has, like, a slight chance of proccing. It just doesn't tell us how often. What are you doing? I'm behind you. This thing is really catching these hands right now. Is it weak? Oh, it's already weak, boys. The thing is really weak. I'm trying to avoid any poison. Just go ahead and go this way. That's not gonna do anything. One get hit in. Oh, we missed our last hit. That's fine. Oh, he's slayed. Okay, like I said, it wasn't going to take us too long, boys. It was not going to take us too long. We can go ahead and loot this body real quick, though. Or will they allow us to? Yeah, okay, cool. And then the Kuliaku isn't too far away, and we're still well within our time limit, guys. We'll finish this in about 16 minutes or less. We had already put damage in on him, so... I like this. I do enjoy this. Just going around hunting monsters, like, straight up is a lot more interesting than the little Zoro Magdaros thing we had going. Personally, I think it's a lot more fun. Oops. Shoot their weapon here. Yeah, that whetstoning, you have to resharpen your blades every once in a while to make sure that you can deal, like, your maximum output damage, pretty much. Pretty sure that's what that means. You could bring your blade all, like, way down if you need to. Oh, the Kuliaku didn't even go that far. I thought it had gotten, like ran away completely. It was good that we fought the Puke Puke first, though. Alright. What's up, Kulu? Heh. Hi. How's that feel? Oh, blast effect went off. I wish those Vigaspores wouldn't pop up, like, now. Cause this isn't the time that we need them. Oh, this is gonna miss. Oh, no, it didn't miss. Oh, Woo! Take that fat damage, and he's stunned. Guys, I think he's gonna die relatively quickly here. Like, really quickly. We have become so OP since, like, the start of the game. Since our first few episodes. Alright, let's... Hold on, we don't want to leave too many parts behind here. Oh, that's just piercing pods. Okay, we don't really necessarily need him. Okay, so he's already limping. We've done, like, nothing, and he's already limping. That blast effect is unbelievable. Blast effect, when it pops off, is like an instant 100. So, can't really argue with that. I wish it had something cooler, though. I think the next upgrade of this weapon is, like, ridiculously good. But this one's also really good as a charge blade. It's definitely, like, by far our highest. Compared to our last paralysis blade, this thing is pretty high up there. Ha! It popped up again. And it's like, alright. Well, that was easy. That took us 10 minutes. 11 minutes. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and loot the body, see what we get. And that's gonna wrap up today's episode, boys. That was fun. Oh, man, that was fun. This is what I mean, like, when you're getting, like, you're constantly getting stronger in this game. You want to constantly get stronger in this game so that you can do stuff like this. Like, obviously, if I would have sat back and treated this as you know, part by part, never play in my free time, then we would have had difficulty, you know, with this mission. It would have taken us much longer. Instead, we were able to kill both of these monsters in little to no time. So, honestly, I'm not complaining. I hope you guys enjoy that more of us just kind of, like, really, really hammering in on these monsters. And there's stronger monsters than this. This is just a level 3 quest. So this is like small, easy stuff. I don't want to make it seem like, you know, we're breezing through the game, because we have not met a lot of insanely powerful enemies. Enemies that are way stronger than us, even in our current gear. So, hey, that's thumbnail material right there. Eh, actually, it's not as quality as I thought. It's all right, though. All right, so let's see what we pulled out of this. That took 9 minutes and 14 seconds completion. Sorry, I... really messing that up, and it was, they give us a 30 minute timeline, so I mean, in all reality, that's really good. And we get 7,000 in money as well, so that's just easy money right there. Easy money. Well, that is going to wrap up today's episode. See if we load back in here. So I prefer to have us in a good setting to wrap up here. Let's make sure that we got everything we need. And the episodes will continue, obviously. I love this series a lot more. I've been getting more and more into grinding for that gear and stuff like that. And I want to bring you guys along for some of those gear grinds in sometime in the near future. Right now, we're kind of stagnant, I'd say, in terms of gear upgrades. As of right now, like, there's not like a whole lot more that we can go for unless it's armor, which we can do that. But at the moment, I'm actually really enjoying our armor because... I didn't get a chance to show you this, guys. Real quick. Look at that. Those stats down there in your bottom right-hand side there. Defense 201. We got plus 10 against fire. No negative debuffs against water. No negative debuffs against ice. And then plus 10 against thunder and plus 10 against dragon. So, guys, the set that we're rocking right now is actually really freaking good. Like, really good. Negative 10% affinity. Elemental 180. And then we got that 608 attack. So, that, like, this set... in general, like, even though it's not, like, meant to be a combination set, kind of, like, it's not something that you would rock together, in terms of, like, blade and armor, but it works really well. Like, I didn't really pay attention too much to it. I just wanted the set, and I didn't realize how good the buffs were and how good your negative debuffs, you don't have them. So, that's going to wrap up today's episode, boys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to leave a like, sub up, share around, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace!